Why does PRP require multiple treatments with short duration in between when first starting treatment? The usual PRP treatment seems to be 2 or 3 injections a month or so apart, followed by yearly maintenance. It seems it would take 3 months to see any benefit because of the hair cycle. Isn't it possible that the first injection could be successful, so an additional injection only a month later would be a waste of money? Wouldn't it make more sense to do the first several injections 6 months apart to determine efficacy before applying another treatment? Could benefit be seen after one treatment?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question which is very basic. You're asking, why does PRP have to be done so frequently? And it's certainly a very understandable question and for the treatment of hair loss. I could certainly assist you with this. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I've been performing hair transplant surgery for that duration. And in addition, I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, which is based on our system of hair regeneration that uses PRP as part of the process. And it actually is a non-surgical solution and alternative to hair transplantation. So I have a lot of experience with the use of platelet-rich plasma, not just for hair, but also in my practice for skin rejuvenation, for acne scars, and for other treatments, wrinkles, sun damage, etc. My intention is to educate and to describe our experience, and in no way am I interested in disparaging any other colleague or physician who is offering PRP as an option for hair loss. From my understanding and from my experience, I think that everyone who's using it is doing their best to see if they can help their patients stop the progression of hair loss. That being said, in our practice, we use platelet-rich plasma, but we combine this with something called extracellular matrix. This is a wound-healing material which was originally intended to assist in the healing of the donor area of a hair transplant, as well as to improve the viability and survivability of hair grafts. Serendipitously, it was noticed that thinning hair became thicker. So to differentiate what we do with our treatment, which we call hair regeneration, which is a customized combination of platelet-rich plasma with extracellular matrix from platelet-rich plasma alone, I can give you some basic understanding. In my experience, platelet-rich plasma alone will stimulate short-term hair growth, and that's the explanation for the frequency. When people come to a doctor and get PRP injections, they'll get some short hairs, and those hairs will grow for a short period. But left alone, they'll stop growing. And that's why a lot of people come to us who have had PRP done elsewhere will say they had to go every month. They often did it without any anesthetic, which certainly after a couple of sessions becomes less than fun. But in our practice, when we do what we do, which is hair regeneration treatment, we have patients who with one treatment will actually grow hair continuously. What will happen is they will stop the progression as well as reverse and thicken thinning hair. In a way, it's a reactivation of growth cycles that are actually thickening the hair rather than allowing the genetic progression of hair thinning. It's successful for both men and women. 99+% of men and more than 90% of women from our clinical data from hundreds of patients who we treat from around the world every year, we have seen that the benefit can really be sustainable without repeat injections. So I think that the answer to the question, of course, is from my experience and from the experience of patients is that PRP alone cannot sustain hair growth. PRP will certainly be beneficial in many other areas of the body, as I described, but for hair growth, it doesn't do the job that you want it to do, which is to stop your hair loss progression. In some ways, it's almost comparable to the effectiveness of minoxidil. Now, that being said, for patients like people like yourself who inquire about PRP, we spend a lot of time educating our patients about the long-term benefit and the strategy we employ with hair regeneration, and such to the point that we have built TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, and we are now trying to bring this technology out to people who may or may not be able to come to us. As we said, it being in New York City, we see patients who come here from around the world who have excellent sustainable results, and we follow our patients closely, and we're able to customize treatments. Sometimes it does take more than one treatment, but we have a system in place based on a lot of clinical data to help our patients get the maximum result. And along that point, I would also suggest that you consider doing something earlier rather than later. The more hair somebody has, even if it's very thin, the better it is, because the volume and density can really have an impact on coverage the sooner somebody comes. We're treating people, both men and women, as early as in their 20s and 30s. But even men and women we've treated in the 70s have also done very well with hair regeneration. So this is a remarkable treatment that bridges a very important gap between medications such as minoxidil and finasteride and surgery, which has the limitations of the number of grafts and the amount of coverage before you run out of donor area. With that being said, learn more about this other procedure, which involves PRP, but not PRP alone. And I think you'll find that there is an option other than doing PRP injections every few months. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question.